So, I got a cherimoya with me today. I finally found these suckers. I've been looking for them ever since I first saw Durian Rider eat it on his channel. And everyone is talking about these fruits like they must be really, really good. So, I finally found one. And so, I'm going to show you how it looks like. So, here it is, this little green heart-shaped fruit. So I guess when it's supposed to be ripe, apparently it's supposed to be a little bit soft. I don't know if this is too soft. I think this is about right, actually, if you wanna just a little softness to it. And I think, yeah, you should be able to split it open if it's ripe. Oh my gosh, yeah. That's super easy. I got the juices running. Oh. Should have had more towels down there. Wow. So it smells a little bit like mango, but it has more of like a vanilla kind of smell to it. I don't know if it's because I had a ripening with the mangoes up there. I don't know if it took its scent, if it took its scent or something, but smells almost like mango. So here's the inside, and if I split it here, I'll show you the seed. The seed is like right hidden right in there. That does taste like vanilla. Here's a seed, by the way. I hear they're toxic, so just toss it in the garden. Let's have a taste test. Wow, that is super good, man. That tastes a little bit like mango. Are these supposed to taste like mango? I had them ripening up with the mangoes up there. Man, this is good. Wow, this fruit is really amazing. It kind of reminds me of watermelon in the sense that there's so many seeds in here. So you just kind of like eat and spit it out like you would with watermelon. Texture is very, very creamy. It's very, very soft. Very, very soft. Super, super creamy. I don't know. The taste is amazing. I'm just trying to put my finger to it. I think it's like vanilla and like mango, like something a bit kind of citrusy, but yet like really, really savory and like, I don't know, like vanilla pudding or something. Or like Oreos. I don't know. It kind of reminds me of a little bit of durian. Got cherimoya. So here's the aftermath. By the way, be sure to have something thicker underneath. I think it actually soaked through to my desk. Anyway, cherimoya has a lot of seeds apparently. So be sure to spit them out. Don't eat them. They're toxic and they're really hard. So if you bite on them, you'll crack a tooth. So be very, very careful. Caution to you, fruit hunter. So the cherimoya would definitely go on my top 10 favorite fruits. Maybe in top five, actually. That was really, really good. So I highly recommend checking out cherimoya if you can find it. It also goes by the name custard apple. Might be a slight variation there, but I know some people call it the custard apple. And they grow cherimoya in South America. They grow it in Asia, Central America, or some other places. I know in California they grow it in the States too, so maybe some people watching this can even buy it locally too. So I got it from Wegmans, the supermarket Wegmans, and it's found in a few places throughout the United States. for about 5:30 something, I think, and it was about $7 or $8 a pound. So looking at the nutrient breakdown here, I mean, you can see that cherimoya is about 176 calories per fruit. Now obviously that's going to vary per size of the fruit, but let's just say it's between 150 to 200. It's definitely not a low calorie fruit, which definitely gets a thumbs up from Bananiac. You want to eat lots of calories if you're going to sustain a raw or a high raw vegan diet. So cherimoya would be awesome if you can afford it or have access to it. Looking at the vitamins here, I mean, it almost has half of the USDA's daily recommendation for vitamin B6. And it's also rich in other vitamins and minerals. And lastly, looking at omega-3s here, it comes at a whopping 23% of the daily recommendations by the USDA. So a lot of people say, you know, if you're a vegan, you're going to be deficient in omega-3s. So just eat a bunch of cherimoyas if you can. And there you go, omega-3 salt. So definitely check out cherimoya. Go maybe to Asian stores nearby your house, or check Wegmans or any other supermarkets that you think might have cherimoya. Seriously, that fruit is awesome, and I'm going to try to get a couple more, to be honest with you, if I can find them. So they're usually around in the, you know, late fall, winter time. So look out for them. Post your comments down below of what you think of cherimoya if you have tried it, and we'll see you guys next time.